TFNN. Headline news update.
Good morning, everybody. I'm Tommy O'Brien, coming to you live from TFNN, 9 a.m. Eastern Time, Thursday morning, 30 minutes to go until the opening bell. And we got markets sitting in red territory right now with the S&Ps just under 3,200, trading at 3,195. That's 24 points in the red. You have the NQ futures minus 128 points, trading 10,553. The Dow off 221, trading 26,544. Oil off 50 cents at 4070. We got gold contract off $8 at 1805. And the silver contract off 11 pennies, 1965. Notes and bonds, a little bit of higher price and lower yield. The 10-year up 4 ticks at 139.15. You're looking at a 30-year up 20 ticks at 180.11. In terms of those bonds, let's see where they're trading. Bonds yielding 0.609%. So approaching that 0.6% yield, you back up bonds. And we are like approaching, you see those highs, we're at the upper end of that high. We bounce around, you could say anywhere from about 138.15 to 139.15, right at the upper end of that boundary with yields of 0.6% on that 10-year. All right, we got a lot of news stories shaping the action this morning. We'll start it off with weekly jobless claims. 1.3 million for the last week. This number coming out at 8:30 a.m. this morning. The market was looking for about 1.25 million. That is the 16th. Consecutive week of a million jobs initially claimed, quite a number, and it looks to be pretty stagnant at that level. We'll see what happens. Retail sales for the month of June coming out as well, better than expected, 7.5% month in June increase. They were looking for about 5%. So retail sales hitting the tape at about 8:30 as well. We got earnings this morning. Couple banks, Bank of America shares dropping as it sets aside another $4 billion for loan losses related to the coronavirus. Morgan Stanley crushing it on trading revenue. Profit of $3.2 billion or $1.96 a share. The market was looking for $1.12. Revenue, $13.4 billion, exceeding expectations by $3 billion. Big numbers in trading for Morgan Stanley, as was the case with Goldman Sachs and JP Morgan last couple days. And Johnson & Johnson, their profits sliding as the coronavirus forces hospitals to forego elective surgeries. We'll start off Morgan Stanley. Let me zoom it in because we're going to open a bit higher from Morgan Stanley. There's your action on their earnings. Pretty muted action, right? Johnson & Johnson shares looks to be up a bit from their close yesterday. And Bank of America shares, though, lower at 23.89. The VIX this morning trading 28.70. Stay tuned, folks. We got a man, Larry Pesavento, coming up live in 3 minutes. And while you're waiting for him, head on over to the front page of TFNN and check out my new report, Rocket Equities and Options. Stay tuned, folks. Larry coming up right now.